As we mentioned earlier on, love is in the air. We are going to talk about love and how to find that one true person for the, and spend it with them for the rest of your life.
I mean, you're a single person. Tell me how tough it is to find that perfect match out there.
It's like going to war, my friend.
It's like going to war, like with your helmet and your makeup and
war paint on, and your girl's like, hooah! And you go out and you come out bruised, you come out bruised, battered, your ego's damaged, your confidence is shattered.
See, this is what you
ugly
when you ask a drama queen these kind of questions. But
ooh, drama queen.
In true honestly, but you are, come on, man. but let us be honest, true. Asian men, we're simply not built that way to be emotionally open, to come forth with our feelings. You know, we were taught since young, hey, big body, you can't cry, you know. So, of course, that sort of thing grows on you until you become quite closed off. And only after you're married, you start opening up. And, the thing is, in this day and age, things go really, really fast. You might just miss the love of your life just like that. So, of course, with us, once again, is, of course, the love guru, Mr. Date Coach, Mr. Andrew Chow, will tell us about the three deadly myths about love.
How
about
that? Good morning, Andrew.
Morning.
Welcome back to the show.
Yeah, it's great to be back.
And you just came in from Singapore?
Actually, I come from Singapore.
Yeah, as in you came in this morning or you stayed here?
I just came in this morning at 5 a.m.
Wow. Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming on. Now, okay, just to recap, last week you talked something about character versus personality. Maybe you want to just recap.
Last week, I talked about the seven qualities to look for in a life partner. So we have the first one, the person must be committed to personal growth.
There you go.
Number two, be emotionally open. Number three, must have integrity. Number four, must be mature and responsible.
Right.
Number five, good self-esteem. Number six, positive attitude. And of course, last but not least, number seven, very important, chemistry.
Chemistry actually comes all the way to the end.
Yes.
Because a lot of people actually judge whether they'll work or not on chemistry first.
That's right.
Well, that's not a running order. Yeah, I mean, as long as you have those 8 points, I think. I'll educate you on this later on.
I'm nervous. I don't have this.
But today we'll talk about some of the deadly myths of love. So do share with us.
What are some of the deadly myths of love? Deadly myths are actually belief about love that we had all along that actually prevented us from having the right kind of relationship.
Really? Okay.
So the first one would be true love conquers all.
True love conquers all.
It's a myth.
It's a myth.
From someone who's married... I start laughing.
Why do you say so? It's not true?
Now, a lot of people believe that if I were to love the person wholeheartedly, however bad he is, whatever bad habits that he has, whatever vices he has, he will change one day. Now, that is not true. Because if that is true, you will be beating yourself up every time. Because you will never be able to love the person enough. So you will feel that it's always your fault. Maybe he is like this because you don't love him enough. So love is two-way. And love, there are a lot of choices you need to make. So true love doesn't necessarily covers all. You need to use your brain, not only your heart.
Okay.
So let's go with number two. Number two would be that you can find true love on first sight.
Oh, love at first sight.
I blame
all these romantic comedies, all these movies that you see where, you know, in the end...
Disney has imprinted all these ideas of, you know, Prince Charming.
And all these Julia Roberts and all, who have imprinted this image of, you know...
Yeah, it is interesting that you mentioned movie because we learn about love and romance through media and movies. Because of time constraint of only 2 hours, they compress the love to the first 5 minutes.
True.
You see, I don't deny that you might find something very interesting and special about somebody on first meeting, but that is not love. In that, feeling good and special about a person does not mean you love the person. So be very clear.
So
love
never
happens at first sight.
Don't get carried away with attraction.
That's right. So it is a lifelong thing. You need to develop it. Now, the thing is, the third myth is your partner will complete you. Totally.
I see.
Fulfill you totally.
This one is Jerry Maguire's fault.
Yeah, and actually, it is again not true because we do have needs, and not all our needs can be met by our partner. So you must still have your own friends. It doesn't mean once you have a boyfriend, once you have a girlfriend,
you lose your own life.
You lose your own life. You lose all your friends, and so on. I have people. Once they have a girlfriend, they lose all their friends for 4 years, and the minute when he called me up, It's a time that he broke up his girlfriend after 4 years.
Yeah. This is what I call it creating a love nest.
Yes.
Exactly. So, and no one exactly. can come in. It's that little love
so,
nest.
So when you hear those words, you complete me, you better think twice, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Right?
So, you know.
Since when do people still use that? That's so 1995.
Yeah. So, no one will be able to, you know, meet all your needs and go, today we go into proper. Mm-hmm. What is the first kind of relationship that won't work? Okay. Number one is you find yourself caring more about your partner than your partner care for you.
I see.
Love, it's imbalance.
Love is two-way. Mm-hmm. Now, some days I love you more, some days you love me more.
Right.
But if every day I love you more and I'm depositing my love into a joint love account, I give, you take. Mm-hmm. When I need it, I come to the account, I find nothing there.
Right.
The account is bankrupt and I'm bankrupt.
I see.
You're not talking about money, right?
No, love emotionally.
Because when you talk about bank accounts, why do you take my money, woman? You think
it's a simile, man.
Joint love account.
Got it.
Number two would be that you are in love with your partner's potential.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Now, the thing is that you got to love your partner now.
Mm-hmm.
So ask yourself, if today he's not going to improve a single bit, will you still want him in 20 years' time?
That's going to be a tough decision. Though.
Yes, correct. So if you are dating an entrepreneur and you always envision him to be a successful multimillionaire businessman, you are going to feel very, very
ripped off, is it?
Ripped off, short-changed.
Short-changed.
When he never realized his potential.
I see. So you paint a picture of him, put him on a pedestal.
That's right.
When he doesn't achieve it,
so
it causes problems.
You've got to love him now as a struggling entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
So anything that he is successful is a bonus to you.
I see.
Yes.
All right. Good advice.
The third one is very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
If you find that you are on a rescue mission.
Or damsel in distress, you know?
So you feel compelled to always help someone in trouble.
So be the protector, so it seems.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So you just imagine that you always feel that you need to do something for the person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you need to pull the person out of the emotional pit and so on.
Mm-hmm.
You're not treating the person as a partner. You're treating him or her as a project.
I see, that's
sympathetic love.
Also, what you've mentioned so far, there's simple mistakes that people make, actually, that people make every day. So when you put it out in point form like that, suddenly you take a step and go, oh.
And actually, I like to add that people like this mistaken sympathy for love.
And that's
very dangerous.
Yeah.
You know?
Dangerous.
The next one is the other way around. You look upon your partner as the role model. So you idolize him, you know, just because he's your boss, just because he's someone, you know, that that you can learn a lot of things from. And you think that that person is someone that you can love, or that person is right for you. Now, I'm not saying people of different status cannot get together. I'm saying that relationship is of two equals. You may be my boss previously at home, but we are equal
In the relationship.
Alright, equal in the relationship. So you don't want to look at your partner as, you see, the thing is that how you like it, if you want to look at somebody else as a mentor and you're always looking up, and if this person is always looking down at you, you're not going to have a good relationship at all.
Mm-hmm. So,